session. Next, we have lined up an AIU business session where vice chancellors may put forth their problems faced in the discharge of their duties and discuss the issues related to AIU body, its head office, and discharge the duties. Also, VCs may share the unique best practices which can help the fellow vice chancellors to improve the functioning of their universities and any other item with the permission of the chair. The same would be chaired by Honorable President AIU, Dr. Tej Pratap, and it will be convened by Honorable Secretary General, Dr. Pankaj Mittal. Over to the chair.
Professor Tej Pratap, yes. Sir, you're on mute, sir.
I'm audible now?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay. Thank you very much. Let's start with open session. My fellow colleague vice chancellors, as has been just said by Master of Ceremony, this is your time now for it's called as housekeeping issues. So housekeeping of universities and the problem that you face for next half an hour to 45 minutes, we have this opportunity of interacting amongst ourselves, universities and AIU business, if
but
you have any issues, any problems you want to raise.
We have done in the last 1 year.
Yeah, and okay, now I hand over the whole this to Pankaj Mittal to put up the business issues and she has upkeep.
Thank you very much, sir.
Yes, madam.
Thank you. Okay. In AIU business session, what we generally do is that we give a sort of a whatever we did in the last year in the AIU, because you are all the member universities of AIU, so you have the right to know what all we did in the last year. So after I make a presentation on what all activities we had undertaken last year, we will seek your opinion on improving the activities. If you want us to do something more, we can always do it. If you want us to change the way we have been working on certain activities, we can change. And if there are some common issues which the vice chancellors want that we should raise with the government, I mean, we are the voice of the vice chancellors because it is an association of universities. So we are your voice for the government as a collective force. So anything you want us to take up with the government, you can always tell us and we will certainly take it up with the government. And similarly, whatever government wants the universities to do, they keep on telling us that if you can disseminate this information to the vice chancellor, it will be very good. And that is also what we do. So first, I will just give a short presentation. It won't take more than 10-15 minutes. I'll share my screen. And are you able to see the presentation?
Yeah. Yeah, put it on slideshow.
Yes, I'm going to slideshow. Yes. So a small presentation on what are the recent initiatives by AIU. First, about the existence of AIU, many of the vice chancellors have joined new to our family. So AIU, now we have completed almost 95 years. It came into existence as a inter-university board on 23rd March 1925 to bring all universities on the same platform. And then it was registered as a society, as the Association of Indian Universities on 29th September 1967. So this, it is that old. And the stalwarts like Dr. Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan ji, Dr. Zakir Hussain ji, Dr. Mudaliar ji, Dr. Srimali, Dr. Shyama Prasad Mukherjee, they have been the presidents of AIU. So you can know the legacy of AIU, that it has been headed by such stalwarts. This is the present membership of AIU. We have 822 universities as the members, out of which 49 are central, 348 state, 113 deemed, 249 private, and then we have institutions of national importance. And then we also have 17 international members as our associate members. So they are basically universities which are located abroad. These are the functions of AIU, liaisoning and lobbying, consultation and coordination. Just a second. I'm just trying to shift it. Consultation and coordination, capacity building, leadership development, research, cultural activities, sports, and what all we did in all these activities, I'll be telling you in the following slides. But one important function which is mandated to us by the Government of India is equivalence of foreign degrees with the Indian degrees. So that is what we do also. So these are the new initiatives. Unfortunately, last year went as a COVID year, and many, many of the activities which were to be held on face-to-face mode, or which we had to do a lot of research, that could not be held. But nevertheless, we used COVID as an opportunity. And what we tried to do was, we increased the visibility of AIU. So if you have seen the AIU website, it has been completely redone. The media presence of AIU is there on Twitter, Facebook, LinkedIn, and slowly our Twitter handle, I mean, it's having more and more followers. So if any of you are not following AIU, and if you want to know that what all AIU is doing on daily basis, you can follow the AIU Twitter handle. It is AIU India, or even my Twitter handle, which is Pankaj UGC. So any of them you follow, you'll come to know that what all AIU is doing. AIU flag has been redesigned. If you see at the back of my chair, there is a redesigned flag of AIU. The AIU building has been is under renovation. I mean, rather, actually, next week, the renovation activity will actually start on the campus. What we are trying to do is, we are trying to create more conference facilities for our universities. Because many a times, the universities which are located in, say, far-flung areas or in remote areas, sometimes if they want to use the facilities in Delhi, for example, the central universities use the facilities for doing the finance committee meetings because it is centrally located. So we are making very good conference halls for you, along with very good stay arrangements. The AIU guest house is also being redone, along with the rest of the office, to take care of the decent facilities to each and every worker in the AIU, whether it is a staff or an officer, everybody will be getting a decent facility. The National Conference on AIU is, because we are trying to club it with the Foundation Day. AIU Foundation Day is 23rd of March. This year we'll be completing 96 years. And every year we are thinking of having the program from 23rd to 25th March, National Conference plus the Foundation Day. But last year, because of COVID, it was a bit delayed. And this year also, maybe it will be slightly delayed again, because we want to hold at least one conference face-to-face. All the five regional conferences were held in a virtual mode. So we feel that at least one conference we should have hold face-to-face. So maybe if we can delay it by a month or so, so that the face-to-face possibility increases. And last year, we also started the AIU Foundation Day lecture series. And the first Foundation Day lecture was delivered by Nobel laureate Shri Kailash Satyarthiji on 17th of August. These are the initiatives which were taken by the AIU during the COVID-19 pandemic. We did recognize that many of our teachers were facing difficulty in teaching online. So we held three online workshops for training the faculty on how to teach online, rather how to teach online effectively. So this was done in collaboration with COSPIR. It saw a huge response. Similarly, students were worried about the placements. So we did an online workshop for placement officers for conducting online placements of students, including internships. So this was done so that they know how to do online placements. We did collaborate with NDLI, National Digital Library of India. And there was also an interactive session of Vice Chancellors with Sadhguru, which was held in a virtual mode. And there was a video message for Honorable HRM also. The university news, if you have noticed, has been redesigned. It is now more colorful. We do have a new design every year and a new color every month. So every color, every month there'll be a different color, and every year there'll be a different design, so that there's a little bit of more vibrance. The university news also has been digitized, and an e-copy of the university news is uploaded on AIU website regularly. Similarly, we were making a book called Reimagining Indian University. That book has been published. Yesterday we got a copy, and very shortly we'll be sending a copy to each one of our esteemed members. And before the publication of the book, we release scholarly articles from the eminent authors of the book every week on the AIU website, so that gradually our vice chancellors can read all the articles, because book comes all of a sudden with such a thick book. So every week scholarly articles were released, and the same procedure we are going to use for the next book, which will be on implementation strategy for national education policy. We have invited articles from the authors, and those articles also, after the editing, will start releasing on the virtual mode, and then finally it will be compiled into a book. We also did 1 week course on community engagement with and university social responsibility in collaboration with PRIYA, which is an NGO. We have also created a WhatsApp group of vice chancellors. There's an easy dissemination of information. Actually, we have 2 groups because 1 group has a limit of 256, so we could not accommodate all. So we have 2 groups of WhatsApp groups of vice chancellors. If any of you is not a member and wants to become a member, please send a message. We'll immediately add you. But this is a very easy source for vice chancellors to tell the fellow vice chancellors that what all is happening in their university, what all new areas are there. Similarly for AIU also, the information can be easily shared. Indian Network of International Higher Education, we are going to establish very soon. You will get a letter about this and what all we are going to do in this. This will be basically promoting internationalization in higher education, and then will be more helpful for the universities which are wanting to do internationalization but don't know how to do it, how to go about it. So this network will help them. And then we also did a webinar with Shri Shri Ravi Shankarji on reshaping higher education. A self-paced free online course is actually available on the AIU website, and that was again developed with Coursera UK. And then we also conducted webinars on how to use various platforms for teaching learning like TCS iON or Microsoft Teams. Because at that time, teachers were finding it difficult, even the students were finding it difficult on how to use these platforms. Now, of course, everybody is accustomed to all these platforms, but we did have live demo sessions on this. These were the 5 zonal conferences last year. They were all held in face-to-face mode. So these were the 5 zonal conferences we held last year. Annual meet was to be held on 23rd to 25th March, but was again postponed due to COVID, and was ultimately annual general meeting was held on June 26th. But the national webinar of Vice Chancellor was held from August 17 to 18, where I was telling about the Foundation Day lecture by Shri Kailash Satyarthi. In the library, what we have done is that we are trying to computerize many of the functions of library. Soul software has been implemented, which was taken from Infinet for computerization. Soft copies of AIU daily news clippings. I mean, if any news appears in any newspaper all over the country on higher education, so those clippings are sent to the vice chancellor. Some of the vice chancellors wish to have it and they are not getting it right now. Please inform us. We will start sharing it with you. And then what we do every month is that every month out of those news clippings, if there are certain very good articles or editorials, we compile them into a compendium. And that is also shared on monthly basis with the AIU member universities. Again, if you're not getting it, please inform me. We will get it sent to you. And then the bibliography of PhD thesis bibliography, which we were compiling, that is now computerized. So now you don't only get the name of the thesis and the name of the scholar or the guide, but you also get a QR code through which you can get the actual text of the thesis as well as the abstract of the thesis. So that has been done you can easily see what all is being researched in the country right now. We are right now computerizing the complete overall total automation of AIU is being done, and Infinet Ahmedabad is doing this automation. So for this, every university has to register on the AIU portal. We have given the login ID and password to all the member universities. If you have not got it, please ask for it. And please do enter the information about the university, because it is very, very important for the success of the AIU portal. We have already implemented the online payment gateway, and all the payments to AIU can be made through the gateway. There's no need to send a check or a bank draft. AIU admission portal is active. That means this portal, but all these portals will be active only if you fill in your information about your university. So in AIU admission portal, we have the information about the universities, that what all programs, academic programs they are running. And those academic programs, like suppose I want to take admission in MSc Physics and I write MSc Physics in AIU admission portal, down will come the list of the universities which are running MSc Physics program along with their details and the URL. So please fill in your data so that the scholars or the students who want to take admission, they come to know that what all programs are there. We have AIU Equivalence Portal, which is totally computerized. You can apply online for the equivalence certificate and download the equivalence certificate on your computer. No need to visit AIU, no need to send any bank draft. It is all automated. Online payment is there, online uploading a certificate is there, and online downloadable equivalent certificate is also there. VC seniority list portal is also uploaded. All the Vaishyas, right now we are into VC seniority list. We are sort of calculating the seniority of all the Vaishyas list, which is used for nomination on the governing council of the AIU, for nomination of vice president and president of AIU. So if you have not filled your seniority, please fill on the AIU portal, for which you have to use the login and password details which have been sent to you. But seniority list cannot be sent in any other manner except for on the portal. So please fill your seniority on the portal. AIU sports portal has also been activated. And now we are also doing rest of the portals like youth affairs or membership and collaboration. The mandate is that all the services of the AIU will be online in future. In internationalization, we have signed two MOUs. One is with UUKI, UK International, and one is with the AIU counterpart in Mexico, that is NUS. So any university wants to collaborate with any of the UK universities or Mexican universities, you can write to us and we can get you in touch with all those organizations. And we also did some collaborations with World Bank and UNESCO and workshops. Research, we did bring out a concept paper on eligible enrollment ratio. That is, how many students who are 12th pass, how many of them are getting admission into higher education rather than considering the complete cohort of 18 to 23 years. So that showed that India is standing at a much, much higher pedestal and is comparable with most of the European and developed countries, the EER. We also held one workshop on emergence of STEM education, on philanthropy, and on world university rankings. These workshops were also held on safe campuses, responsible research and innovation, online platforms. And these were the online courses which we run during the COVID time, developing digital practitioner, professional development of faculty. This AIU Quedex portal is a portal in which there are something like 100 courses for the faculty for their online professional development. So any of the faculty members, you can request your faculty members that if you want to learn many, I mean, it could be even how to write an impactful research project. It could be how to be a good communicator, how to do the online teaching. All these things are being taught on this online platform. So AIU Quedex, you can go to AIU website and see this. But these are very good programs for the faculty members. Then AIU Priya, we are running a blended training program on fostering social responsibility. And then short-term courses on Safe Campus in collaboration with Martha Perel Foundation. These were the publications which were much acclaimed. I mean, India Higher Education Profile, which gave the information, higher education statistics in a pictorial fashion, and state-wise information was also there. That was very much liked. Then we published a book on reimagining Indian universities. A COVID response toolkit was made, which was done in collaboration with Jindal Global University. And in this, there's a step-by-step procedure for how to reopen the institutions after the COVID. And then a book on protecting academic interest of the students, sharing best practices. I mean, during the COVID, what all best practices they followed, that is under preparation. And we did conduct a survey on preparedness of Indian higher education institutions for online education. That survey report will also be soon, will be published very, very soon. These are some of the glimpses of the research activities. Then in youth affairs, the National Youth Festival was held at MIT University. South Asian University's Youth Festival was held at SOFEST. First AIU National Moot Court competition was held in Rajiv Gandhi National Law University, Patiala. We have also formulated a Youth Affairs Policy 2020, which was also uploaded on the AIU website. And then we held a digital event for the students, Kush Artistic Corona, which again saw a huge response. We got 2359 entries from about 600 higher education institutions. These were some of the glimpses of the AIU Youth Affairs activities. In sports, we held the first Khelo India University Games. That was a very, very pride moment for us. The Honorable Prime Minister of India inaugurated them. Games were held in Keat University. And at a very large scale, these games were held. Our university students and the college students were very happy about it, the type of exposure they got in these Khelo India University Games. And these were the other activities in which we participated in the last year. And the next Khelo India University Games will be scheduled in, will be held in 2022, mostly in February. And please encourage your university students to participate. Right now, trials are going on. So the students can give trials and compete in the zonal competitions, and the winners of the zonal competitions will go to the Khelo India University Games. These were some of the glimpses of the Khelo India University Games. Equivalence of degree, I told you, this has been fully automated. We are also changing the rules from duration approach to the credit approach, because earlier we were saying that if a foreign degree is of the same duration as of Indian degree, then only, I mean, apart from other conditions, then only we'll give the equivalence. But now we are shifting to credit approach. Similarly, for some institutions who are running PGDBM to MBA, earlier we were saying that if you have NBA accreditation, then only we can give you equivalence. But now we are considering three international reputed accreditations like AACSB, AMBA, and EQUIS. If this is there, then also it can be considered at par with NBA. And more than 2,000 equivalent certificates were issued last year. So these are some of the activities which we undertook last year. So now the house is open. The president, sir, over to you for taking the views of the member universities. Please. Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you very much, Dr. Pankaj, for giving a complete overview of what has been happening during Corona period. Wonderful indeed. House is now, floor is open for discussions. Any questions, anything my colleagues would like to say? You can raise your hands and speak. Anybody?
Everybody is happy.
Yes, right? Please.
No, yes. I would like to ask a question, Dr. Pankaj.
Yes.
My video is not opening, so I'm unable to, switch it off.
Don't worry, your voice is
yeah. So it's a very nice, just on the front of the equivalence, since, for last decade, many type of master's courses have been floated in India, right? And when it comes to job of the students in the college schools, particularly, they get subjects like, I'm from botany background, so it is either botany or zoology or environmental sciences. So can we, take out a list of the programs for which we can give an equivalent certificate?
See, our mandate given to AIU is of equating foreign degrees with the Indian degrees. So okay. If you're talking about a subject like a physics person, can that person get, or maybe a person who has got a degree in a particular specialization, can he get appointment as an assistant professor in the related subject or not? So that is a issue of relevance. And that is decided by the concerned university. So as a university, you will decide whether in the physics department, can I appoint a person of a student who is not exactly in physics, but in a related discipline, that is to be taken care of by the university. AIU does not have that mandate. We are only dealing with the equivalence of foreign degrees with the Indian degrees.
No, I because this is a kind of forum we can talk about. NCERT doesn't recognize like various subjects, they take appointment in certain subjects. So this there should be a debate that if students are getting degree, PhD degree and other degrees in other courses, can they get job in the schools? Please raise this point. This is a really pertinent question,
Okay. Will you be kind enough to write a one-page write-up on this so that we can take it up with
us? Oh, yes. We will certainly do it. Thank you.
Send it to me. We will certainly
okay.
do it.
Thank you.
I also have a second question. Can I ask?
Dear Vendraji.
Yeah, similar question. You know, we in our university had a student from Uganda, while AIU and their own university consider that the equivalence at the plus two level for admission to be pharmacy course, it's he can get admission in India, but Council of Pharmacy Council of India, they said no, these are not the subjects which he should have passed at the plus two level. They should be according to the Pharmacy Council of India. So there has been a confusion. While there is no confusion at the level of AIU and the Ugandan system, there was some problem at the level of Pharmacy Council of India. How to settle these kind of issues? This is one of the problems which sometimes we face.
Sir, the equivalence of foreign degrees with Indian degrees, although AIU is doing, but for professional subjects in which professional councils are there, this right rests with them. So similarly, for medical council, we receive a number of issues. Like they say whether their 12th class is equivalent to our 12th class or not, we give the equivalent certificate for the 12th class. But then they say that you did not study biology till this level, therefore you cannot get. I mean, there are cases in which the student has done the complete MBBS in the foreign country, but when he has to come and practice in India, he is not able to practice because he did not do that biology subject in the 12th class. So these are the issues which have to be taken up with the respective statutory professional councils. So if you wish, we can talk to them. Similarly, we are in touch with the Bar Council. They are saying that we will do the LLM equivalence. We are saying you have no business to do LLM because LLM is an academic degree, not a professional degree. Similarly, Council of Architects says we will do MArch equivalence. So we are talking to many of the professional bodies that, I mean, if a degree is a professional degree, maybe you can have a say. But if it is an academic degree, which is a postgraduate degree after a professional degree, then it should be considered as an academic degree and AIU should be doing it. And we have also written to the Ministry of Education about it, that they should give this mandate to AIU rather than the professional councils.
All right, Professor Vind, I think we have limitations there, definitely. But if the authority was with us, then you would be helped, of course.
Yeah, thank you.
Anyway, we have only 2 minutes left before it is 12:45. Any quick question or we go back to valedictory session? Seems okay. Everybody is satisfied, but small things.
I am to just congratulate and compliment the chairman, Dr. Tej Pratap, and the secretary general for the good work. I have been even listening the 2 days this program, and secretary general, Madam Pankaj, presented whole his work. It's excellent, especially in the COVID period. I congratulate AIU and both of you. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Let's take them as concluding remarks for this open house session. Thank you, Parminder. Okay. Yes, over to the organizers for valedictory session.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Thanks to the president and the vice president of AIU.
Thank you. Yeah, I would like to thank the Honorable Chair and Convener for the session and discussing the challenges in a very comprehensive manner. Thank you, Dr. Pratap and Dr.